This is for those that's lost like the Bermuda Triangle. I'm here to wake y'all up.
Pot of gold right here, man. This is it, man. This is glory.
The first thing we gotta do, man, is just know what we gonna do with this cream when we get it, man. Right. I'm not trying to just be sitting on motherfucking 200,000 and acting like I'ma just be a drug dealer all my life, son. I got bigger and better plans, son.
No doubt. We gonna
you
move
know
on,
be
man.
Fucking with anybody,
son,
man.
Long as the love and the trust is there, son, we gonna.
Shout out to Brian Larkins for the comment. He always shows support and always comments. Salute. So the comment reads, you need to make a video showing media bias towards Nas to uplift Jay-Z from B. Elliott Wilson.
After Illmatic, this guy was looked at as maybe one of the best MCs of all time. Now he's just a guy who makes, you know, some good records, but he's not, you know, he's not living up to that promise of that first album.
Dream Hampton. Pitchfork, Rolling Stone, Vlad TV.
Best work. But, you know, but that's just my personal opinion. I'm always going to hold it up to Illmatic, right? I look at Illmatic and I look at, you know, Stillmatic.
Whatever it was in the rhyme, you could recite the rhyme, you could play the rhyme. It was a sport. It was about his career.
I don't want to just be on the radio 24/7 with new records. There's nothing wrong with it for any other artist that does. But for myself, I like to step away, so when I come back, I have something to talk about. And because of that, and because I like to experiment with music, he tried to manipulate the people and the listeners and the fans to feel otherwise, like he was the king.
Hot 97.
When it comes to greatest hip-hop person, it's Jay-Z.
Right, greatest rapper.
When it comes to greatest rapper, he's in that conversation right in the top three or four, but... And, like, sometimes I think Nas can be a better rapper than Jay, but Jay's career makes Nas's look like, frankly, a disappointment.
Even a Breakfast Club.
Let me tell you about it. I mean, Ether was cool. It was a good record. Don't get me wrong. But it's angry as fuck. He sounded so emotional. And it's elementary bullshit. You dick-sucking lips. Rockefeller died of AIDS. That was the India chapter. It's the oldest jokes you use to somebody. Being gay, having AIDS. You know, it's just corny to me. Like, you look like a camel. Like, Jay-Z takeover was actual facts. Jay-Z said, yeah, I sampled your voice. You was using it wrong. You made it a hot line. I made it a hot song. And you ain't get a coin. You was getting fucked then. I know who I paid, God, Searchlight, Publishing. It was all facts. He sampled Nas's voice, didn't pay Nas for the usage of his voice. He paid Nas's publishing company. Yeah. That's facts. It's facts.
And I don't own Nas's publishing. Never did.
So when Jay-Z says
he was fucking with him.
I know who I paid, so, God,
Searchlight publishing. So here's the truth about that story.
Right.
I was the head of promotion, CHR promotion at Def Jam.
Right.
We're about to put out Reasonable Doubt. And Biggs, Dame, and Jay came to me and they said, hey, we got to clear the sample on Dead Presidents.
Mm-hmm.
I'm out for Presidents to represent me on Philmatic. So I said, yeah, it's not a problem. Give me a check for $2,500 and I'll clear it. It's not a problem. They were like, that was it? Yeah, I said, that's it. I went to Zombo. I saw the president, Richard Blackstone. I said, hey, this is what we're going to take. I said, but we'll take 50% of the publishing. So Nas owns. Yeah. So what I love to say is, while Jay likes to say that, Nas owns Jay's publishing. Jay does not own Nas's publishing.
Wait, what? From that record?
Correct. From that record.
Correct.
He took 50% of the publishing.
Exactly right. I made that deal. Mm-hmm.
Wait a second. So when Jay dropped Reasonable Doubt again in 2005, right? That was 2005 when he did the thing at
any printing of any printing that says Dead President, Nas owns 50% of that song.
Like, this is clown shit. KD3. I didn't have to die so that they could call me the great one. That was a direct shot towards Biggie and Pac, saying that they got bigger after they died. I didn't take a couple albums, people said it from day one. And then when he was talking about it didn't take a couple of albums, he was talking about Jay-Z. Basically letting y'all know he the GOAT. And he been the king since day one.
Now, since Illmatic was dropped April 19th, 1994, a lot of other albums have come out. I mean, a lot. Cuban Links, Life After Death, Reasonable Doubt, All Eyes on Me, Late Registration, Get Rich or Die Trying, Marshall Mathers LP, Good Kid, Mad City. A lot of albums have come out.
Talk about it.
Ain't none of them surpass Illmatic. them. You may love them and think they're, none of them have surpassed Illmatic.
And this run got them scrambling to come up with BS narrative lies. You gotta do that video. Truth always has a counter to lies. That's a fact. So with that being said, about to produce this material and produce this video.
A few months later when he came at Nas with The Takeover. Now that song plus Nas's No Holds Barred response either qualify as two of the best battle records ever made, hands down. But a good diss record is not necessarily a truthful one. I mean, sometimes things get a little exaggerated. So we decided to do a fact check on the claims made by both lyrical warriors.
Went from nasty Nas to Esco's trash. Had a spark when you started, but now you're just garbage.
Claim number one. Jay says Nas has fallen off since his first album in 1994, Illmatic.
That's a one hot album every 10-year average, and that's so.
One hot album every 10 years? Let's take a closer look. Nas's Illmatic was a success with critics, but since then, sales of his albums have dropped, and so has his critical acclaim.
Now, this is a perfect example on the tricks that the media play right in front of your face. Now, exactly what Sway's saying, that's not what's being read on the screen. Now, on the screen, it says Nas' second album went double platinum, 2 million. The album after that went platinum again. It sold 1.85 million. Then the album after that sold 1 million. So all of them albums went platinum. Now, he talking about the critically acclaimed album rather than the sales, but then he trying to make it seem like he is talking about the sales. Now, let's compare the sales to Illmatic to all of the other albums that Nas put out and how did they sell after Illmatic. The album debuted at number 12 on the US Billboard 200 charts, selling 63,000 copies in its first week. However, its initial sales fell below expectations, and its five singles failed to achieve significant chart success. Despite the album's low initial sales, Illmatic received rave reviews from the most music critics, who praised its production and Nas' lyricism. On July 17, 1996, the album was certified gold by the RIAA, and on December 11, 2001, it earned its first platinum certificate after shipping 1 million copies in the United States.
But Jay's claim may be outdated, since Nas released the appropriately titled Stillmatic on December 18th last year, garnering critical acclaim and impressive first week sales.
It's taking hip-hop back to hip-hop.
Both of them songs, and then you got the Rewind joint.
I'm gonna have to go probably Rewind.
Rewind.
I'm gonna go Rewind.
Nas Rewind.
You know what I mean? And I can't just because it's me. Listen, it ain't, like I said, it ain't even about all that. Yes. This is about like, yo, like skill on this record right here.
Yeah.
Remember, you know what I mean? On this record right here, and just, it was just how the thought that he put into that. You see what I'm saying?
Like, you know, Nas just was always the golden child. He was always the one, period. You know what I mean? So, me being a lyricist, these are the MCs I studied.
Me and Ray, I can remember we was listening to him one day. And he just started laughing. Cause the nigga was a straight golden child. You know what I mean? Like he had bars.
My previous video already stated that in 99, that's when I got introduced to Nas, the I Am album.
Since I learned about Nas in 99 from the I Am album, with the Hate Me Now.
People fear what they don't understand, hate what they can't conquer.
I was attracted to Queen's rap.
So I was a Nas fan, to say the least. So in 2000, that's when the QB Finest album dropped. Nas was still bubbling in my eyes.
Ooh, yeah, baby. That's that joint right there. Ooh, come on.
Ladies make it hot, thugs make it hot, make it oh, you didn't wanna know whose life was written. The life I'm living, the ice, the women, the kites descending to life is bitten. From breaking atoms to Illmatic to going platinum, shit did change course since ripping it with main source. 9192 time flew out of the blue, time for a new young king to rule.
And the QB Finest album just dropped, and you know they whole thing is Queensbridge is the biggest projects in America.
We from the largest project, yo, the biggest on earth, Queensbridge.
So, you know, I wanted to go see it. So, that year, 2001, that summer, that's when I went to go visit family for a summertime vacation. And that's when I went to Queensbridge. This is before my seventh grade year in middle school. Nas was still bubbling in my eyes. And then in 2001, that's when the whole Jay-Z takeover shit, Summer Jam shit came out.
The fuse was lit at New York's radio station, Hot 97's 2001 Summer Jam.
So, you know, everybody was like, yeah, you know, it's over for your man, because everybody knew I was a Nas fan. You know what I mean? But even back then, in 2001, when I was 12, 13, I wasn't into what everybody else was into. I wasn't into because it's hot, because it's popular, because everybody else doing it. I know what's good to me.
$1 billion ambition.